jumbo frames. As you can imagine, those are frames that are simply very big. So big that you are not supposed to use them. Well, at least when connecting to other people's networks. But you can use them in your own networks if you want. If you don't know what frames are, they are like transportation units for Ethernet. Similar to how goods get transported in trucks on the roads, data get transported inside frames between Ethernet devices such as your router and your computer. The rationale for using jumbo frames is very simple. Just as you can transfer goods faster with bigger trucks, you can also get more out of your equipment with larger frames. Let me show you. I have a 10 gigabit connection between two of our most powerful routers. Now if I run bandwidth test, you can see that the most throughput that I can get is around 9.5 gigabits per second. This is pretty typical for a 10 gigabit link using the standard frame size. More importantly, if we look at the CPU usage, we can see that 4 cores are being used around 80% and the total CPU usage is 21%. This is a very powerful CPU with a lot of cores, so it can handle this type of load. But on a lower end device, our throughput could end up suffering significantly. If we want to maximize our throughput and improve the overall performance of our routers when transferring large files, we can bump up our frame size to jumbo size. To do that, we should double click on our interface in the GUI so that we can change what is called MTU. Now here you can see that there is a value called max L2 MTU. That is like a cap, a maximum MTU value that we could possibly set on this device. A typical jumbo frame size is 9000, so I want to enter that value both in the L2 MTU and the MTU fields. In some cases, you need to set the L2 MTU to higher value than the MTU, most likely if you are using VLANs. But in this case, I can set them both to the same value. Then, of course, we also have to do this for the device at the other end of the link. Now, when we launch the bandwidth test, we are getting 9.9 gigabits per second, so our throughput is now really close to the bandwidth of this link. The reason for this is that each frame has an overhead that eats at our bandwidth. So, with less frames being transferred and their payloads being bigger, we are getting through more useful data. In this case, the difference is not very large, but if you look at the CPU, the overall usage is just around 4%. That is 5 times lower. While it didn't matter here, in some other setup, that could be the difference between getting 3 gigabits per second throughput or 9 gigabits per second. The only thing you need to factor in here is that all the involved devices need to use the same MTU. So if you are transferring files between two computers, you would have to configure them to use jumbo frames from your operating system. Otherwise, setting higher MTU on only some of your devices could be counterproductive. See you next time.